Hi everyone, and welcome back to New Jersey Ballet's new virtual series, Ballet Stories. My name is Nicolas Noa, and today we'll be reading through a story of Cinderella. Let us begin. Once upon a time, a beautiful young girl named Ella lived with her haughty stepmother and her two ugly stepsisters. The stepmother and her daughters were very jealous of Ella's grace and beauty that they forced her to do all of the housework. Poor Ella scoured pots, scrubbed floors, and swept fireplaces. Most of the time, she was so dirty that the stepsisters called her Cinderella. One day, the prince invited all of the maidens of the kingdom to a ball, so that he could choose one of them to be his wife. No sooner had the stepsisters left to prepare for the ball than an old beggar woman came to the door. Cinderella gave the old woman something to eat. The beggar woman thanked her and went away. Alone at last, Cinderella dreamed about how much fun it would be to be able to go to the ball.
Thank you.
"What shall I wear?" Cinderella wondered. The stepsister sneered. "You vain little ragamuffin! This invitation isn't for you!" They made Cinderella work even harder to help them get ready for the ball. Not long afterward, the beggar woman returned, but this time she changed into Cinderella's fairy godmother.
Maybe I will do better with the mother. she decides to sleep. And at that moment, the beggar woman comes to the door again. But this time, she has something for Cinderella.
"To thank you for your kindness, I will help you go to the ball," said her fairy godmother. Whereupon she called the four seasons to help prepare Cinderella for the ball. Her fairy godmother warned, "You must return exactly at midnight, or the spell will be broken and your clothes will turn back to rags. The hours of the clock will remind you." Then she chose a large pumpkin from the garden and changed it into a golden coach to carry Cinderella to the ball. And Cinderella hurried off to meet the prince.
Turn to rags. The hours of the clock will remind you. You must be exact. Stroke of midnight. Hours of the clock will return. And now, Cinderella, the four seasons will present you with a beautiful cape and jewels and a gown, so that you will be the most beautiful person at the ball. And I have another surprise for you. Suddenly, we see a huge pumpkin. What can this be? Fairy Godmother commands the pumpkin to disappear. And on comes a beautiful coach with two white horses that will take you to the ball. Godmother commands the horses to go forward and take Cinderella to the ball.
The ball was well underway by the time that Cinderella arrived. The prince took one look at her and fell head over heels in love. They danced into the night. Cinderella enjoyed herself so much, she forgot all about the time, until the hours of the clock came to warn her. With just moments to go before midnight, Cinderella ran out of the palace, leaving behind one of her slippers.
Prince is aware of someone arriving. Who is it? He sends his servant. Cinderella arrives in her beautiful white gown, with her crown of diamonds and her long train. The prince took one look at her and fell madly in love. Her train, and the prince asks her to dance.
Now the prince is going to dance for the court.
Returned.
night. And Cinderella is enjoying herself so much, she's not thinking about the time. Festivities continue with the ladies and gentlemen of the court. Cinderella and her prince are enjoying each other so much, they dance into the night. Cinderella is forgetting something. Just at that moment, the hands of the clock return. Come to warn her. Cinderella, as the clock strikes 12, your clothes will turn to rags. You must remember. Thank you.
Cinderella runs from the palace. She has left one of her slippers behind. The prince's servant finds it and brings it to the prince. The prince says, "We will search the kingdom until we find Cinderella."
The prince searched the entire kingdom for the girl whose foot fit the slipper, and everyone, including the stepmother and stepsisters, tried in vain to put it on. Then the prince noticed Cinderella standing quietly in the corner by the fireplace and urged her to try. The slipper fit perfectly. The stepsisters and their mother wished that they had not treated Cinderella so badly. For her part, Cinderella forgave them and even invited them to the palace, where she and the prince went to live happily ever after.
Thank you.
Cinderella. Professes his love for her and asks her to marry him. We will go off to live in my castle.
Thank you for watching our new virtual series, Ballet Stories. Please join us on Wednesday, May 12th at 7:30 for our next presentation of Don Q. Support for our new virtual series was made part by a generous grant from the Union Foundation. Thank you again, and to learn more about New Jersey Ballet, please visit our website at www.njballet.org.